for the LGBT community.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, you going on. I'm like, you
know, it's not a lotto.
But that's what I would do. That's because, you know what I'm saying, LGBT community.
This dope, this hope, with this dope, this hope. Sheesh, wait. Is it lit? Don't you know that from coast to coast, with this dope, this hope, with this dope, this hope. Sheesh, wait.
Yo, what's going on? It's your man Herbtone.
And it's your man PZP.
And we are the hosts of the Herbal Tea Podcast. Hey, y'all tuned in to Verse TV, man.
Verse TV, let's get it.
Make sure y'all rate and subscribe. And don't forget to comment, man. Check us out.
Check us out all day and tomorrow.
Where did the name Herbal Tea Podcast come from?
Hold on. Okay. I knew you wanted this one. Go ahead. Hold on. So, let's take it all the way back. Rewind that back to like June 2019.
Oh, man.
Herbtone come to the hood and invite a young brother like me. Talk about he wanna do a podcast. I'm like, podcast? What you talk about? What? All right. Fast forward. You know, maybe a couple months, we like planning this shit out, rehearsal, you know what I'm saying? We get to the point where we want to talk about a name. Yeah, two names. I don't even remember the second name.
Me either.
I don't remember the second name, but the first name he hit.
Wasn't important. Good.
The second name ain't even important. The first name he hit, he said Herbal Tea. I said, bitch. I remember I was in his kitchen, in his hood, because, you know, we chop it up all the time in his hood, you know what I'm saying? And normally what we do is when I go to his house, we talk about music anyway. We talk and we always smoking. So that's just like, that was the impetus for all of that. So putting it all together, just the way he came up with the name and the way it's just like, you know what, let's just fucking go with it. And I loved it from the beginning.
Hello? Like,
let's do that.
And
let's
it's still there. And it's stuck. And you guys are doing it.
It's stuck. And we've just moved on. We moved forward with it. So, yeah, we've been working on this for quite a while. And, you know, I'm really, really happy that we're here. And
Yeah. Why did you name it Herbal Tea, though? Is it just because you smoke an herb, or just are there any other tea?
It kind of made sense. You got the herbal, and then you got the tea. We're talking about the tea in the community, the news, the culture. And then, you know, the music kind of just got that ring to it. Herbal Tea Podcast, you know what I mean?
It kind of gives wellness. It kind of gives a sense of... It gives a sense of balance. It gives like a self-help type thing. Because when you think of herbal tea, you think of like chamomile or peppermint tea or mint tea and shit like that. Stuff that's good for you, good for the soul, good for the heart, good for the spirit. You know what I'm saying? And we want to give that. That's exactly what we just kind of flip it in on its ear. Because the herbal obviously alludes to the herbal essence that we all know and love. The cannabis.
I like that.
And then the tea, you know, is obviously everybody wants to spill the tea. Everybody want to, like, put that tea on them, you're already. So, you know, putting those things together just felt natural.
Nice. Sounds about right. It's been going great, and it sounds like it all fits together. So what's the main thing you want our Verse TV audience to listen about the Herbal Tea Podcast today, like walking away from?
It's for Q+ artists by Q+ artists. That's the biggest thing. You know, it's one thing to have a show about, you know, a culture and a community, but to actually be from that community and actually be involved and actively involved, you know, in that community. Like, we're still recording artists to this day. So we know what it takes to go into this music, to go into marketing and get your name out there, stuff like that. So we empathize with these artists, but we still, you know, we have the expertise to critique the music at a level that's not only informative, but entertaining as well, because we know what we're talking about. So that's one of the biggest things we want to get through to everybody in the audience. We are artists, and we're doing it for the artists. So it's a community-based podcast, definitely.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, get the music on your podcast to be, like, critiqued. How could they do that?
The quickest way to do that is probably on IG. Y'all can hit us up at herbal.t.pod. We have all our information up there, all the links. You can get, that's the quickest way to get to the actual podcast, to the YouTube. Hit us up, DM us directly. If you ask us questions. We also have an email. So we have herbal.t.pod@gmail.com. Y'all can also email us. But like I said, either way, you can get all that information on Instagram. That's the quickest way to hit us up.
Nice. And this is just a sidebar question. Do you guys ever have, like, guest hosts or anything? Are guest people at co-host with you guys?
We haven't yet. It's not really in the plans. We kind of tinkering. We're doing maybe, like, an offshoot or something else. But nothing is set in stone right now. So for right now, it's us kind of doing our thing.
If you ever do any guest spots, I want to just come in.
A lot of people have been asking, believe it or not. It's kind of crazy. But, you're the homie, so.
Look, I was there from day one, okay? Okay. You can't tell me nothing. I'm definitely history with you guys. This is the last question, and we'll ask our OBT podcast, and we'll talk about some verse T questions. What's going to be next for you guys for the Herbal Tea Podcast? And what should we be expecting for you?
That's a loaded question. Like, honestly, we got a few things in the works. We just trying to improve. You know, we honestly just dropped. We only two episodes in. We got the third episode dropping this week. We just getting our feet wet, you know what I mean? We just trying to get better. We still working on our chemistry. We getting our formula right and everything. And we just want to keep improving, getting better, and keep getting the word out. That's the biggest thing we want to do, is kind of just spread the audience, make people aware of it, and get people to listen and watch. Because I think, honestly, once people kind of, everybody who sees it is has some kind of reaction to it. Like, it's evoking emotions, it's starting conversations, people are really enjoying it, and it's just about, you know, getting it out there and making sure people are paying attention to it, and that's really all we focus on. Everything that comes after that is just going to be great, you know?
Awesome. Well, thank you guys for that. Herbal Tea Podcast, and gentlemen, if you heard it here first, if you have any questions, comments, or anything, you definitely can put it below. They'll be looking. Also, reach out to them on their social media, but let's get into our Verse TV question. So, without further ado, our first question is this. If you had all the money or/power necessary, what would you do to make change to feel most beneficial to the LGBT community? We'll start with this one.
We'll start here.
Easy.
All right. If I had all the money in the world.
Money and power. What would you do to make change?
All the money and the power in the world, I would take over the government, and I would put all my homies in there, because, you know what I'm saying, I'd be president, and then Ertone, you know what I'm saying, he's going to whatever you want to do, you want to be Congress, or you bring all the homies and be Congress, you know what I'm saying, Billy Hood, Suwannee River, going to take over the judicial branch, you know what I'm saying, throw the hammer down, but really, it would be sort of like that. I would be able to turn over the whole system and bring all the representation that is needed in this world, because this world is so much bigger than just white, old white men. And all the representation that we need to have needs to be involved. So I would like make sure that, you know, we are well represented. We could take care of ourselves. Family is good. So my mom would have the biggest house in the world, you know what I'm saying, wherever she want to live, whether she want to live in Virginia, whether she want to live in Honduras, you know what I'm saying, all the homies would have big-ass houses, We driving cars. That equity is going to be lit. Everybody going to be dripping.
For the LGBT.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, you going. I'm like, you
know, but that's what I would do. That's because, you know what I'm saying, LGBT community. Y'all didn't let me finish. But for the LGBT community, of course, you know, I'm saying we need the representation. We need all of us to be feeling like we are the best and that we have, you know, there wouldn't be trans women out there, black trans women who are at risk. So, you know, we're going to be able to protect the most vulnerable people in the society. And that wouldn't even be it. It wouldn't be vulnerable anymore if I had all the money. I'm just saying. Because the systems that perpetuate that system would not exist. So that's kind of my thing. You know what I'm saying? There would be no more AIDS. We will eradicate that. We're going to put the whole cure out. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's going to be rid of HIV. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that.
Man, thank you for the earth tone. What do you think about that? What would you do most beneficial for the
That's a big, big question. My thing is with any kind of change, any you know, major societal issues that you want to target or anything like that, I think it all starts with, like, the youth and kids. Because, you know, we learn certain things in society. Like, we don't always start with all of these barriers, this hatred, and all of these certain things. Like, all of this stuff is learned, and it starts, like, in school and these systems. So I think one of the biggest and most vulnerable groups in the community is, like, homeless, Q+, LGBT youth. So I think if we could, you know, focus on, like, program and schooling for them and, like, housing, like, you know, nice dormitories and stuff like that for them to be able to go to and not worry about having to, you know, get food and clothes and stuff like that, to be able to put them to school and give them a certain, you know, proper health care and sex education that they need at that age, you know what I mean? Like, different stuff like that to target that specific group. You know, who knows what could come out of that youth and, you know, those lives and the amount of the people you could change with. Things like that. So I think, you know, starting with something small and focused like that would be one of the things I would try to do with, you know, a lot of money. Just really give the right amount of money to teachers to, you know, pay them to have a workable and livable salary to be able to teach the kids the way they really want to, resources and stuff like that. I think that would be dope to have some kind of program like that.
Gotcha. Awesome. So the next question is this. It starts with a quote.
You can hit me up at Earthtone Music, EARTHTONEMUZIQ. The Herbal Tea Podcast is at herbal.tea.pod. And
PZ, where to find you?
You can find me, of course, at IKP4Presidents on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, everything. And of course at Herbal Tea Podcast, herbal.tea.pod, you can find all of us there. And, you know, also in the streets.
In the streets.
You know, just like that. And you heard it here first. This was All the Tea with Verse TV, ladies and gentlemen. This was our exclusive interview with Herbal Tea Podcast. You can be tuning in with them. Cause what? They'll be here all week. They have an awesome time with us on our Homos Talk Show, and that was super dope. So they're gonna be here all week. Please tune in, like, comment, subscribe, follow them, follow their podcast, follow what they're doing, hit them up, and try to slide to the DM. You know what's good. And I'm your boy Charlie Spears of Sound.
Not slide to DM.
We out.
I mean, that might be the only place you're gonna slide.
Well, you can't get to go online, so. Hello. Ooh, I heard that. I got that too.
Dope, this hope, where this dope, this hope, sheesh, wait, is it lit? Don't you know that from coast to coast, where this dope?